Hi folks, today I will talk about the VFD driver PT6312. I had already made a video on the reference of the driver, the micro PD16312, which is the equivalent driver. This driver supports between 11 grids and 16 segments, has VAE of the less 24 volts DC, support the 24 keys, and have a control to the four LEDs direct from the driver. It works with 5 volts DC or 3.3 volts DC as a power supply. I use the built-in Arduino 1 clock to generate the base time for the clock I present in the VFD, but there are another videos where I suggest connecting the RTC3231. It is being very easy to adapt to the code example I use it and let in the link below the video. I made this video to help the difficulties to reusing this card because they have two peculiarities that made the task difficult to the amateurs. The first difficulties arise because the VFD has 7 independent grids, but actual the 6th and the 1st grids are used as only one. The second difficulties arise from the fact that the 2 digits per grid do not have the same distribution for the segments. The segment A, for example, start at 1 and the first digit, and the second digit it starts in the 2. To solve this difficulty, I made one with the shifter resistor. This maintaining the same table for the construction of the numbers and can solve these difficulties, okay? This is the map from the distribution of the segments by the grids, okay? You see here the first grid, second, third, first, second, fourth, far. And if you look to these 2 grids in this position, this block here and this block here have the same number, okay? Every time you polarize the grid number 5, because start 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is mean grid number 5, you polarize this grid and this grid also, okay? Here you can find the wells and you start here from 1 until 8, and after you have the segments A, F, G and H, because I make mention here our access to the groups of the segments. For example, in this first grid you can find here the numbers from 5, 6, 7 and 8, because the first part of the remaining digits, the remaining numbers belongs to this grid, you can find here. You have the 1, 2, 3 and 4, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, and after you will continue here, 5, 6, 7 and 8. 8, sorry. The blocks of the byte is different numbers. Here I use numbers, here I use the letters, only to make the difference between the 2 groups of the same grid. For example, if you look to the grid number 3, you can find here the letters A, B, C, D, E, F, and G, and the numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 8, sorry. This belongs to the same grid, but you can see The segment A belongs to the letter A, and the second digits of the same grid, the segment A belongs to the second bit of the byte. The segment A will be here for one and will be here for the other, okay? This is a connector from the port, and the first pin belongs to the VAE, is less 24 volts. After you have the filament 1, filament 2, this is two pins from the filament, the GND, the VCC, you can use 3.3 volts or 5 volts DC. Data in, data out is these two pins have a shunt because you can use to read and to write. After you have a clock, strobe, and also you have a pin to the infrared if you want to use, okay? The codes to the keyboard, I have these keys. And you can see here the numbers or the positions of the bit. You can find in the platform Arduino when you start the serial monitor, okay? This is the byte 11 03 21 41 05 81 09 81 21 and 41. I have three levels of the byte because I have 24 keys. This is mean I have the level 0, 1 and 2. This is belongs to 3 bytes. And in this keyboard or in this board, the keys only use the level 0 and 1. Of course, you can adjust the configuration how you prefer. This key is not working. I don't check why. But all the other all the other keys, you can use, for example, to adjust the minutes. Let me see which is the keys is working. Okay, this is open. Down the minutes, up minutes, reset, up hours. Down hours. You can adjust the keys like you prefer, okay? This is a little board, belongs to the DVD player. I make the animation here of the wheels only to be more easy to regard the functions of the keys and the software, okay? These little two bulbs stay on every time you put 5 volts in the board. This is the monitor of the serial port to the Arduino, and at this time I'm regarding the 3 bytes belongs to the key maps present in the board. Every time I press a button, the corresponding bit changes the value, and after you can do it any kind of actions of the code. I don't apply any kind of the concerns to the actions belongs to each key because it's only a test and is not important, but you can adapt to the your code and your actions without difficulties. Okay?